When it comes time that our superheroes are up front, if you would like to take pictures or video, if you would leave the center aisle clear so that our camera can get a picture of what's going on, so that our people at home can see the cuteness and feel the joy as much as they can. I would invite my friend Silas to come up, and he's going to tell us about some ways that we can connect.
You can join us at this Tuesday at 3:30 at Pioneer Park for summer story time. We meet under the trees just past the restrooms. This week's stories will be We Are Water Protectors, Two Tall Houses, and The Pow Pow Fish Cleans Up the Ocean. Summer dinner church begins this Tuesday at 5:30. There will be a potluck dinner at Reverend Michelle and Mike's house. After dinner, there will be a casual Bible study and conversation based on Psalm 1. Sign up today in the back or email Reverend Michelle. I want to invite Phoenix to come up and lead the call to worship. Please stand.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, O my soul.
I will sing praises to God all my life long.
Happy are those whose hope is in God, creator of heaven and earth, who is forever faithful.
Seeking justice for the oppressed and for the hungry.
Setting prisoners free and opening the eyes of the blind.
Lifting up those who are bowed down and loving the righteous.
The Lord protects strangers and upholds the orphan and widow.
But the way of the wicked is brought to ruin. The Lord our God will reign forever,
for all generations. Praise the Lord.
Great job, Silas and Phoenix. Thank you. Before I ask you to greet each other, there is an announcement on the back of the bulletin. The second one about the notes for the grant school teachers. Amazon and I did not understand delivery dates, so those will be available next Sunday or this week if you happen to be by. We're going to just write a little note of encouragement to the teachers at grant school, teachers and staff, in preparation for the start of the school year.
Welcome to Hero Hotline. Our heroes had such a great time this week. All this week we've been learning about how heroes are called together to serve God. I'm Professor Watson, and I want to introduce, this is Supermere.
Hi, everyone. Thank you for allowing your heroes to join us for VBS. We had a great time learning new things together.
Well, we sure have. And so what was your favorite part, Supermere?
Favorite? Meeting our heroes each session, learning stories from the Bible, or those awesome Hero Hotline tunes, learning all the ways we can answer God's call. There's not just one favorite.
Okay, but isn't there like one part you liked? Like something you did or said every time we got together at the Hero Hotline headquarters?
I really love learning and sharing our hotline verse with everyone.
Oh, good one. That's right. Our hero verse, our hotline verse, helped us keep focused and remember that we're all about the Hero Hotline. And it's in Romans chapter 14, verse 19 that says, "So let's strive for the things that bring peace and for the things that build each other up." Every time we say this verse, "Remember, heroes," we are reminded how important working and living in community can be, and how by following Jesus, we can be a part of bringing peace and building each other up.
I love that, Professor Martin. And do you know what's better than saying our hotline verse?
What's that, Supermere?
Well, it was living out that verse. Like when we went to the Good Shepherd Ministry Center and helped in the food pantry.
That's right. Do our heroes remember when we went to the Good Shepherd Ministry Center? Do you remember? What did we do there? Raise your hand if you remember. Phoenix.
We helped
in the food pantry. What did we do? How did we help in the food pantry? Kingsley.
We go inside the bread and put all the food inside the bread.
That's right, Kingsley. We weighed the food first, right? We had a lot of boxes. And then we carried it. And it was did you guys work together when you did that?
Yes,
you did. You helped each other carry the food into the great big refrigerator. Mila.
We also got the flowers.
Oh, we did. You all got a gift at the end of flowers that you also were able to bring home. That was really special. Anybody else want to add anything about our experience? How did that make you feel about helping that day? How did that make you feel?
Happy.
Charlize.
Happy.
Charlize says happy. I felt really happy too. We got to serve together and we knew we were helping the people in the community have enough food because many times people don't have enough food here. Yes, Kingsley.
I was a medium.
Yes, you were a medium, huh? I love it. We had such a terrific time. And we also learned that day in our Bible story that even Moses did better when he worked together with others. That story helped us to see how we grow stronger as we turn toward God and others and away from just trying to do it alone, because we can accomplish more together. Well, thanks to all of our friends and our families. Thanks for all of families who brought your kids with you today also to support our children. Not all of our kids could be here this morning, but we're just grateful for the ones who could be to celebrate all that we've learned and shared this week. I also want to thank Reverend Michelle who led us in our Bible story every day, and Miss Mandy who led us in our music. Miss Bella, our science center, and Mr. Austin, our recreation center. Chacha did our crafts. And of course, we want to thank Supermere. Can you say thanks, Supermere?
Thank you, Supermere.
Thank you, Supermere.
You're welcome.
Let's go ahead and actually, doesn't sound like someone we know? Well, you know what? Sometimes we work together. right? And in this case, we're working together to make sure that Supermir showed up today. You all are so smart and good listeners. So let us pray, okay? Let's put, you can put your praying hands together, or you may place them at your side, whatever you want to do. We're going to say a prayer before we end our time together here. Thank you, God, for our time together at the Hero Hotline. Thank you for our leaders and our families who've given their time and talents to make our learning special and fun. May we continue to find ways to share God's love with those around us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. All right, so now you can go ahead and have a seat with your families, and we're going to continue with worship.
That we know, or situations that we know, that don't need Julian's nephew?
Craig.
Diagnosed with cancer. We've been praying for, hold on one second, Charlize, I'll come to you next. We've been praying for Don Curry's daughter, Ruth. She had heart surgery this week. They ended up having to replace rather than repair the heart valve, but everything went well, and she is healing. Charlize, do you have a prayer? Say really well. Oh my goodness. One of your cousins died from cancer. That's sad, isn't it? So many of us have lost people. I'm sorry, but thank you for sharing that with us. Are there others? All right, how are our paper airplanes going? I haven't seen any fly yet. Go ahead, let it fly. Watch out for people's eyes, though. Thanks, Emily. Oh, maybe there's Nanny who can pray for those this week. Let us join together in prayer. God, we give you thanks for the gift of today, for the gift of this time and place to worship. We give you thanks for those who have gathered here with us. We give you thanks for this week of vacation Bible school and for all that we learned, for the time together to laugh and giggle and squeal and sing and do all of those fun things. We thank you, God, that you sent Jesus and that through Jesus you call us to follow him, to learn about who he was, what he taught, who he cared for, so that we can follow and do those same things in the same way. You help us through Jesus to love people, to use our whole selves, our minds and our hands and our feet and our hearts and our voices to serve your people. We give you thanks for the Good Shepherd Ministry Center, for the clients that they serve each week in practical ways, giving them food and diapers and clothing and a place, and people who offer help just because God asks us to. We ask that you would bless the peanut butter that we collected this week as it will go to the Good Shepherd's food pantry. May it be a nourishment to the people who use it. God, we give you thanks for those prayers that have been lifted today. We pray that you would continue to be with Joan's family and all who are grieving her loss. We are thankful for visitors this morning, for families who are here together, for friends that have come. We're thankful for each other, for this community of faith, God, where we come together to worship and to get filled up so that we might be ready to go out in the community and serve. We pray for Craig and all who are concerned about him. We lift you, his doctors and medical team. Pray that you would give them wisdom, that they would have treatment that would help him. And we pray for Charlize and her family as they lost their cousin to cancer. Give them peace and give them comfort. God, use us to be peace and comfort and love and care and a listening ear and a helping hand in the world. We pray all of this in Jesus' name, the one who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power and the glory forever. Amen.
Today's scripture is Psalm 146. We will be reading from the Holman Christian Standard Bible. Hallelujah, my soul, praise the Lord. I will praise the Lord all my life. I will sing to my God as long as I live. Do not trust in nobles and man who cannot save. When his breath leaves him, he returns to the ground. On that day, his plans die. Happy is the one whose help is the God of Jacob, whose hope is in the Lord his God, the maker of heaven and earth, the sea and everything in them. He remains faithful forever, executing justice for the exploited and giving food to the hungry. The Lord frees prisoners. The Lord opens the eyes of the blind. The Lord raises up those who are oppressed. The Lord loves the righteous. The Lord protects the foreigners and helps the fatherless and the widow, but he frustrates the ways of the wicked. The Lord reigns forever, Zion. Your God reigns for all generations. Hallelujah. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. As we prepare to hear the message, let us sing together the summons, number 2130 in the Black Hymnal.
Jesus didn't call to be his first disciples people who had it all real people who were flawed and made mistakes just like we do. He called fishermen, business owner, a tax collector, and they were the bad guys of the time. He called one who was working to overthrow the Roman government, and superheroes, listen, Jesus called a thief, someone who steals stuff from other people to be one of his disciples. These were real people living real lives who responded to Jesus' call to come and see what his life and his ministry were all about. And the cool thing is, Jesus is still calling people. He still is calling us, you and me, today to come and see, to come and follow. Our second lesson was that heroes are called to help others. And we looked at the story from the Old Testament, from the Hebrew scriptures, a story from the book of Exodus of three women who this week we looked at God's wonder women. They were Shifra, Pua, and Miriam. And each of those three women disobeyed the order of an evil king in order to do what they felt like God had called them to do. The actions that each of those wonder women did enabled Moses, who we talked about, to be born and live. And Moses was someone who God called to follow God and to serve and to help others by freeing the Israelites from slavery and from taking them away from an evil king into a place of safety. Moses, in the Hebrew scriptures, was responsible for saving the Israelites. And if we look at the New Testament, Jesus, much later in history, was responsible for saving each of us. We also looked at heroes are called to work together, and you heard a little bit of this. On Tuesday, we went on a VBS field trip, which was so fabulous, and thank you again for arranging it, Reverend Smith, because it gave us an opportunity to go to the Good Shepherd Ministry Center and not just see or learn about or collect peanut butter for this ministry center. We got to see what they do. We even went in the freezer. Closed the door, and let me tell you, we had been walking around, and the freezer felt really nice. And then we helped. We worked together to help them process some food to feed people who are in need. And that is so much of part of who we are called to be as a church, as a community of faith. We're called to work together, each with our own gifts and talents to make a difference in the world. We also learned that heroes are called to listen to God. We then moved over to the New Testament. We had a quick visit to Matthew's Gospel and the story of the Magi, the story of the wise men who came after Jesus was born, who God asked them to go, and there was another bad guy who tried to use the wise men to do his evil work. So many bad guys, but the wise men listened to God more than they listened to the evil king. They followed a star, they found Jesus, they gave him gifts as an act of worship. The Magi's willingness to listen to God, just as Moses had listened to God, meant good news for God's people. It meant good news for us. We looked at that heroes are called to show grace. Friday's story was about another bad guy named Saul. And he was very much against anybody who was trying to follow Jesus, even to the point where he was working so that they would be arrested. Can you imagine? For following Jesus. But God found in God's self this love for Saul. Saul was one of God's children. God loves all children. And God wanted Saul to know that love in his heart. And Saul became blind for a few days, and God called this other guy, Ananias, to come and help. Ananias was a follower of Jesus, and God said, Ananias, I need you to help. Can you go to Saul and help him? Now, if you knew there was a super bad guy, and someone said, hey, could you go help us today how to live, what to do when life is difficult, what to do when life is filled with joy. Our scriptures teach us and give us comfort. They give us guidelines for righteous living. Our scriptures teach us about God and about Jesus and who he was and what he taught, what our relationship with him is. They help us learn who God wants us to be today in the midst of, in the context of, whatever we are facing. So today we start a new series looking at the book of Psalms. We're going to look at one psalm each of the 4 weeks, and then look at a different psalm at summer dinner church on Tuesdays. The Psalms are this book in the Bible filled with writings that help us understand the Hebrew people thousands of years ago, what they were thinking, what they were afraid of, how they worshiped, how they celebrated God's goodness, what they struggled with. The book of Psalms contains poetry and philosophy and wisdom and history and short stories. It's this one book that's comprised of a bunch of smaller writings written over 1,000 years, with this whole book of writings. There are 150 psalms. Some of them we think we know who wrote, and many of them we don't, but we think we might be able to figure out. But it was many different writers. And the final verse or verses, there's 5 sections in the book of Psalms. In each of those books, the last verse or verses is a hymn of praise to God. I think Psalms is one of those sort of go-to books for us when you're looking for something. If you need peace or comfort or wisdom or assurance, and there are lots of places, many Bibles have a list of what Psalms to go to when you need what, and certainly online you can find where to go when you're feeling like you're needing something. One of the questions I came across this week is this: should we read the Psalms as history or theology? And that made me stop and think, are we to look at the Psalms as history, as a recording of someone a long time ago, what they were facing and what they did? Or do we look at them as theology, as a way for us to learn something about God today? We could read them as history, the record of thoughts and prayers and songs of people who lived so, so long ago. And in that case, it would be a bit like we're reading their recording or their journal of what was happening at the time. Psalm 78 is written as a praise to the ways God guided the Israelites. It starts with the Epaphronites, armed with a bow, turned back on the day of battle. They did not keep God's covenant, but refused to walk according to his law. A group of people who didn't listen to God. But in there is this verse, and he, God, brought them to their holy hill, to the mountain at his right hand. So even in this psalm where it starts in a difficult place with people who have not followed God and not listened to God, we read that God is still there calling to them. What if instead we looked at the Psalms as if they were a window into conversations with God? What do we have to say to God, and what does God have to say to us through these ancient words? In the early 20th century, German scholar Hermann Gunkel began to use this method of form criticism as a way to classify the different types of psalms. And he did this to help himself, but it has become so useful to help us determine what the original purpose might have been of each of these psalms. And then figure out how they can be helpful and relevant to us today. So he categorized the Psalms into these categories: laments, both individual and communal, thanksgivings, hymns or songs of praise, royal psalms, wisdom psalms, and then with so many things, there's a little section of others. And we can determine by defining the passage, we can define which category the psalm falls into by looking at the form and content of each of them, and they fall into, if you study, these categories. So all of that is background. Today we look and man who cannot save. When his breath leaves him, he returns to the ground, and on that day, his plans die. In simple terms, in ways that we might understand it today, we can hear and know that the only place we can fully put our trust is in God. Other humans will fail us. We as humans will fail other people. But God is where we can put our trust completely. So if we are reading this theologically, what does it tell us about God? We look at verses 5 and 6. It says, "Happy is the one whose help is the God of Jacob, whose hope is in the Lord his God, the maker of heaven and earth, the sea and everything in them. He remains faithful forever, executing justice for the exploited and giving food to the hungry." Just as the writer of this psalm has expressed, our happiness and our hope come from God, the one who created the heavens and the earth and everything, including us, that lives in them. God is faithful. God is just. Always. There is then in the middle, at the end, this repeated call to praise. And we see that in verse 10. The Lord reigns forever. Zion, your God, reigns for all generations. Hallelujah. So in this psalm, this hymn, we have this opening praise to God, this middle about what is it about God that we should offer our praise, and ends with this reminder to offer praise to God. So what does this psalm tell us about God? If we put it all together, maybe I hear that God is worthy of our praise because God is trustworthy. God is a source of happiness and hope. And I don't know about you, but I think we live in a time where we need to know where we can put our trust safely and fully. We need to know the source of our happiness. We need to know where we can find hope. And so this ancient psalm has meaning for us today. What does this psalm tell us about our relationship with God? We can learn that God, above anyone else, including ourselves, is to be trusted. God will never fail us. As Christians, we know God and we continue to know God better through a relationship with Jesus. And so we're called to follow. We're called to follow Jesus, to watch and read and study who he went to and where he spent his time and who he spent his time with and who he cared for and who he loved. And then find the ways for ourselves to do that same thing. God continues to call to us. We don't always recognize it, we don't always hear it, we don't always believe that God is calling to us. But God continues to call to us. It is an opportunity for us to listen and to pay attention for that. I think all of this psalm points us to this call to serve, just as we did this week at VBS. Will we listen for that call to follow? Are we ready? Will we come and see what the good news of Jesus is all about? When we do that, when we listen and when we follow, we'll see that following Jesus is about loving and serving. In Psalm 46, we read that God seeks justice, gives food to the hungry, frees those who have been imprisoned or oppressed, that God loves and protects and cares about the fatherless and the widow. This week at Superhero Camp, we learned that we can partner with God and be superheroes as we listen for and follow God's voice as it calls to us. Let us pray. God, we give you thanks for all that you have done for us. Across all of history, from the time of creation even to today, you have loved us. You don't love us from afar, you love us from close up. Help us to have ears and hearts and full eyes that listen for you. Give us strength and courage to follow when we hear you, to go and serve and love and care for your people. We give you thanks, God, for strengthening us to be superheroes for you. Amen. I'll invite you now, the usher will come forward with plates in take these gifts from us, the gifts of our resources, the gifts of this peanut butter, that you might use them to feed and care for and love your people. Amen. I want to invite the superheroes to come back. Superheroes! Ways that change the world.